All right. According to the candidates who are preparing their IELTS exam, the toughest module is reading module, as majority of students face many problems while attempting or practicing for reading module. Don't worry, I'm here to solve your problems. But let's roll the intro first. Hey there, this is Simran from IELTS with Simran. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Through this channel, I will provide you information related to IELTS, its concepts, tips and techniques for improving listening, reading, writing and speaking, and useful vocabulary to use in IELTS examination. In other words, everything about IELTS. Let's begin with the reading module. The introduction to reading module says that the reading module of IELTS is of total 9 band score, and you will be given an hour to complete the given task. The one thing that is important to note down here is that the reading module of IELTS is different for academic and journal training. As in the academic reading module, there are total 3 passages that are considered as the long passages. However, in the case of journal training IELTS, the reading module has 3 sections, but these 3 sections are divided, or I can say subdivided, into further 2 more sections. An interesting fact is that the 3rd section of journal training reading is similar to the academic one. Talking about the timing, in both the cases, or I can say in the both type of IELTS examination, the candidates get an hour to complete their IELTS reading test. So the reading test of academic students, in the passage 1, passage 2 and passage 3, the difficulty level of passages are not equal. It means that one of these passages would be easy one, one of would be moderate one, and one of these passages would be difficult one, definitely. And the question distribution in these 3 passages is according to like 13, 13 and 14 questions in each passage of different types. However, in the case of journal training reading, as there are 4 subsections and 1 long passage, so these subsections are also according to the difficulty level. I can say that the section 1 is the easy one, and the difficulty level increases as we move towards the section 1, 2, 3, 4 and the last section. The main difference between these two is one, there is one more difference in these 2 things, is that the passages that are appeared in the academic reading, these passages are always related to the academic content, or I can say the academic ideas, right? However, in the case of journal training, these are related to social or academic text. The sources of these passages are different. Like, you can face these kind of passages or the same difficulty level of passages when you read any journals, any editorial page of any English newspaper, any magazine or any textbook that is related to the academic curriculum. So that's main things about the reading module. Moving towards the types of question in reading module. There are about 8 to 9 types of questions in reading module, which are presented in different forms to check your reading ability. For example, in some of the questions, your knowledge for vocabulary will be judged. In some of the questions, your knowledge for grammar will be judged. And in some of the questions, you need to translate the meaning to mark the accurate answer. So according to that, the different types of questions are, first one is multiple choice questions. Multiple choice questions, or we can also say MCQs. In these kind of questions, the type of question presented is like there will be one question and for that question there will be four options. By reading the passage you have to make it clear that which of the option is accurate according to the reading passage. So you have to mark that option and you have to answer that write the answer of marked option on your answer sheet. Talking about the next type of question are fill in the blanks, which also has some subcategories. I can say that, like, first type of blanks that you will face in case of fill in the blanks is sentence completion, in which there will be one long sentence and you can find a blank at the beginning of the sentence, maybe in the middle or maybe at the last. So you have to fill the accurate word by reading the passage. Second type of question under fill in the blanks is completing the table, flow or labeling the diagram, in which there will be blanks in the form of a flow chart or in the form of table or in the form of a diagram. The third type of question under fill in the blanks is summary completion. Summary completion. I can say that summary completion can be of a summary of a whole passage or it can be a summary of two or three paragraphs. You have to underline the keywords in this summary completion and mark the accurate answers or fill in the blanks, right? So moving towards the next category, these are critical thinking questions, or we can also mark it as true, false, not given. Or the second option for these is yes, no, not given. Although these kind of questions are quite similar, but there is a basic difference between these two kind of questions, as true, false, not given questions are the information which is provided in the case of true, false, not given question is that information is fact based. Means if the sentence is a fact or if the sentence is proved by a fact that is presented in the passage, then your answer would be true. Or if the fact is disapproved, then your answer would be false. Or if the neither the proved fact is given nor the unproved fact is given, then your answer would be not given. However, in the case of yes, no, not given, the question types are always opinion based. Means if you agree with the opinion by reading the passage, then your answer would be yes. If you disagree with the opinion according to the passage, then your answer would be no. Or if you are neither agreeing or nor disagreeing, then your answer would be not given. The next kind of questions are list of headings. As we know that there is a passage in the reading module and there are different paragraphs which are labeled by different letters like A, B, C, D. What we have to do in the list of heading question is there will be a box in which different headings are marked. Then you have to read the paragraph and you have to give a suitable title for that paragraph by analyzing from the list of heading table. You have to assign a proper heading to the given paragraph. So that's the kind of list of heading questions. Next kind of questions are classify the information, in which you have to classify the writer's views. Writer views means as there are certain reading texts which are based on biography or which are based on a person who has researched something important. So in these kind of questions, what you have to do is the sentence which is given, you have to mark that the sentence is said by which person. For example, if there is a sentence that is the philosophy of some person, you have to mark that this sentence is said by Mr. Singh. That would be an option given in the reading questions, in the classify the information text, right? So next kind of question under this category is, so the next type of question is answer short questions. In this case, there will be a question that is asked from you. You have to answer that question by reading the passage. For example, there will be a question that some of the product, in which year that product has been discovered. So you have to mention, just give you the year. Like for example, your answer could be that in 1999. So that's the answer for this question. So these are the different kind of questions that you will face while practicing for the reading module. I hope you found this information useful. Stay connected with me to understand the different kind of questions, as in the further videos I will elaborate that how you can attempt these different kind of questions with proper tips and techniques. Feel free to explore more videos on my channel, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button and press the notification ring bell to get updates related to new posted videos. Thank you, all the best.